Welcome back to the checkpoint. We are at police checking out on security in Kampala metropolitan area, where seven schools actually have had incidents of robbery. And we are looking into a case where one teacher died at a school, St. Andrew Kagwa Secondary School, and a guard got injuries during this incident. We are talking to Kampala Metropolitan Deputy Spokesperson Luke Owoyesigyire, who is telling us about this security incident. Yes, we continue with our conversation. And I'm wondering, do you have any advice for parents who are scared of what is happening and are wondering which school is next?
Parents and guardians, it is unfortunate that such incidents are happening. We have been talking, we are doing everything possible to ascertain who exactly is behind this. And of course, the aim of all this is to stop it. How do we stop it? Making sure that we investigate these incidents, identify the culprits, take them through due process if arrested, and arraign them in courts of law. And of course, with the objectives of having a conviction on the cases they participated in or could have participated in. So we are very optimistic with the current force that is available, the current tools of investigations that we have, and also the relationship the police is putting up with the schools, in especially the areas, in their areas of responsibility. The relationship is also being enhanced to see that we respond and away from making sure that we identify who committed the crimes previously. We have to make sure that such incidents don't happen again. So how are we going to do this? We assure you that we shall enhance our patrols, both mechanized and also foot patrols, making sure that our hotlines are there for response in case there is any attack at any school, so that efforts are put in place to make sure that there is a deterrence. If the patrols are there, if the response is good, there will be a deterrence of such activities not happening again in the future. But likewise, we are upping up the issue of receiving information and responding on it, which is very important in making sure that we stop future crimes. Whenever there is suspicious activities in the areas you stay in, as parents, as school owners, as students in school, if you see any suspicious person around school during the day who is not a student, because some of these civilians get a mix-up and you see a person is not a student, is not a support staff at school, but because you don't care kind of attitude, you ignore it, and at the end of the day, this person was doing some reconnaissance and there will be an attack in the night. So make sure that you are out there for such faces that are not familiar, and also we are urging the PTAs to sit down and also vise up means on how they can enhance on the security within the school premises. Yes, we control the outer, the outskirts of the schools, but we cannot secure your children within the school, because that is basically, as of now, not a question that we can dwell into, because away from the fact that we don't have manpower, There are a lot of schools which our officers cannot guard at one single moment at a go. But we can always manage the security outside of the school. So inside the school, PTAs need to sit down and see how they can put measures in place, like CCTV cameras, upping up on the guards, the equipments they use, and of course making sure that they are paid regularly by their bosses. Because we can also have these guards. You pay the dues to the company, but the company doesn't pay the security guards. And these our security guards on ground will neglect the work they're supposed to be doing, hence the attack. Or they connive, because in one of the incidents, especially that of St. Andrew Kagwa, one of the security guards is on the run, and we are hunting for him, so we don't know whether he connived and participated in this activity or not. So you see that kind of attitude, where we could have some security guards conniving with the thieves, is also something that we are trying to question. So make sure that they are paid properly and well fed, without keeping other factors constant.
Okay. Have you had an increase or incidents of robbery within Kampala metropolitan area?
First and foremost, Kampala metropolitan area is a very, very busy type of area within Uganda. It is where we have the biggest population in the country, and businesses, manufacturing, most of them are within this Kampala metropolitan area. So yes, it is the area that will always register more crimes compared to others, especially in issues and crimes. Crimes that are majorly focusing on the monetary aspect, because many of these items that are stolen are sold for easy money, and not to engage into terrorism or any other thing. But most crimes that happen in Kampala metropolitan are related to do with money, and these thugs will do everything possible to see that they rob and go away with these items, which will later on be sold and to other people for monetary purposes. So we do register, I would say, the biggest number of crimes within the country in Kampala metropolitan because of that aspect.
Yes. Some of these incidents, of course, are phone thefts as well, besides the usual robberies that break into businesses and make off with either money or injure people in the process. But you do have, for example, the mobile money thefts that have been reported in the media lately being on the increase. Mm. Have you made any headway in catching some of these thieves?
I'm not aware of any mobile money thefts currently. Yes, we had that kind of problem, especially before COVID-19. It was quite a big problem. And what we have is now electronic fraud within the mobile money business, which of course sometimes attributed to the parent companies, telecom companies, and also some tricksters who trick many of these agents into sending money.
Yes, those that call you like and that. Tell you that your number is not registered, you need to have it registered.
That is the kind of problem we are facing with. But issues to do with aggravated robbery or the mobile money agents, it is something that has scaled down ever since we got out of COVID-19.
Okay. Yes. So those kinds of thefts, how are you handling them? How should someone also guard against them?
Ideally, we should remain vigilant. The problem we have in Kampala metropolitan is that people are too busy, and too busy about what concerns them. But we need also not to ignore some small aspects of life, like engaging with the community and making sure that we follow up some things we don't understand. So when you ignore many of these things, people you don't understand within the community, we shall always be faced with such challenges. So people need to be careful wherever they are. If you're in a fenced area, get to know your neighbors, because many fenced areas in Kampala metropolitan have like 10 houses, 15, sometimes 20. But you find that we don't know each other. None of us knows the other in this kind of community we stay in. And many of these have brewed criminality, where you find the neighbor renting a place because he wants to rob another neighbor. And after that, they will abandon the place or go away. So we need to be very, very vigilant as members in our communities. If you see anything suspicious, work with the police. I think that is the most important thing, and also the security structures you have in your communities, work with them to see that we stop any type of crime.
You see, there are these cases where you have someone call you. For example, they know what you're doing. Mm. Maybe they know that I am Vivian and I provide nursing services, for example. Then they call me and ask me for my nursing services and then tell me to pass by somewhere and then pay some money there. And they are literally robbing me as well.
Mm.
Are those contacts able to be tracked if I came and reported to police?
Yes, we can track them, but in most cases, people tend to ignore that aspect of tracking, since it is time-consuming in most cases.
Yes.
So most people don't report such cases, unless a lot of money or property has been stolen from them. That is when they always come.
Thank you very much. Well, that has been our week's checkpoint.